Welcome to another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today we'll be looking at the measure tool and using a scenario to help us understand it. Okay, to kick things off, I want to create a scenario, and that is your friend has sent you this JPEG on the desktop and he wants you to open it. He has a message and it says, I want you to create a really cool minimalist piece of art for my wall. The only measurement I've got for you is the ceiling to the floor is 94 inches. So this wall here, your response is no problem, I've got you. So you go ahead and close that. You have Affinity Designer and you have the JPEG, it's all you need. So click on the JPEG and just drag it into Affinity Designer. Let's expand. So the JPEG is in Affinity Designer, and obviously a JPEG is quite small and we want to work to true size. We know the size of the wall is 94 inches. So let's go ahead and set up our document so it makes sense for the work we're going to do. So head on up to Document Setup and go to Document Units and click on Inches. You can see the dimensions of this document, 19 inches by 14. Click on OK. So I don't want to work to this scale because this is tiny. So what we're gonna do is use the measuring tool so we can work at scale. So down here on the left-hand side is the measure tool. Click on that. And now you can see the cursor icon is a crosshairs. So I'm just gonna quickly show you how to use this. So just click once and then just drag out in whichever direction. And you can see it's showing us inches. A few tips on how to use this. If you want to measure straight down in a straight line, just hold down shift. And then you can just drag out and you know that's a perfectly straight line. What if you want to drag over to the left? Well, you can also use shift when it's over there. But another easier way of doing it would be to just click on the left arrow key on your keyboard. And then it keeps it in this straight line. You can see it's red. If I want to go vertically, I just click on the down arrow. I can start measuring down. You can see as I move the cursor slightly further away from that green line, there's a red dashed line, and I'll show you how that works later on. But for now, I'll just press escape, and we're going to start our measurement from the top of the wall, and I'm going to click on the down arrow key, keep it vertically, and I'm going to drag all the way down till I get to the bottom of the wall. So I've gotten to the bottom of it, and I've clicked once. It's saying it's 11.3 inches. We want to work at scale, so we know the height of this, don't we? It's 94 inches. So up here in the context toolbar, it says assign drawing scale. So I'm going to click on that. And I'm going to enter in 94 inches, and then I'm going to click apply. So now we can see it says 94 inches there in our measurement. So from this point, anything we create will work to that scale. So if we go ahead and click on the rectangle tool and just click and drag out a shape like this, you can see down here in the transform panel, or if I just click and drag it again, you can see it says 53 inches by 25 inches. Now we're working in the correct scale. So I'm going to choose something that's going to work for us here. So I'll just switch to the move tool. And I would have liked this sofa to be more centered, but I'm just going to place it around here for now because they can always move the sofa. Now I'm going to go down to the transform panel and I'm going to look at the measurements. I want to round off these numbers a little bit. So I'm going to type in 50. So it's 50 inches wide and I'm going to make it 26 inches in height. Great. We will create a document. It's exactly that size to create our artwork. But before we do that, I just want to measure how far away this is from the sofa. In order to do that, I need to create another box so that I can use the measuring tool to snap to it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this same box that we've got here. I'll just hold down Command, click, and drag. So now we've got a duplicate. I'm going to change the color of it. So I'm going to get rid of the fill up here on the top right. And I'm going to give this some kind of pink outline. And I'll make that slightly thicker, the stroke up here. Maybe somewhere like that will do. And I'm going to zoom in and just lay it down to near the top of the sofa. So about here will do. I'll just drag it out to about here. Okay, so I want to know the distance between the artwork, because it looks good where it is, and the sofa. So because we have this box, we can measure between the two. So my snapping is turned on, which is going to help me to get the exact measurement. So I'm going to click once here. And you see, as I go down, it snaps to the line, but I want to measure vertically. So I'll click on the down arrow. You can see it's green and I'll just go down until it snaps into place. You see that snapping into place? So I'll click once and that's saying it's just over 10 inches. So once I finish the artwork, I can tell my friend to mount the artwork around 10 inches above the sofa. Also, the other measuring option I was referring to earlier, if I just head up here where it says point, I'll just click once and I'll drag out. I want it to be completely horizontal, so I'll click the left arrow key. And as I drag out and down, You can see, I haven't clicked anything, by the way. You can see this dotted line, this dashed line. I can snap, because my snapping is on, to this box that we've drawn down here. So that's a point. And the reason it's snapping to this point is because in this box, there is a node on each corner. If I wanted it to snap to about here, I would have to create another node on that box. But for now, it's on this point, and that says 38 inches across. You could tell your friend that it's 38 inches from the left edge of the sofa. So let's go ahead and press escape, and I will click on the move tool. And this box here, I want to add a node to it, a snapping point. So I'm going to go up and click on convert to curves, and I'll go down and I'll just tap here. There's no reason for me to do that on here, but potentially this will help you. So I'll go back onto the measuring tool again, and I'll click on our point up here. I'll click on the left arrow key, and I'll go down and I'll just go across until it snaps to the point. See, there's a point there now. So now it's showing me that's 25 inches. So if you need your artwork to line up to certain points, you can use that feature. Okay, let's press escape and create the document for the artwork. So we know it's 50 inches wide by 26 inches high. We're going to go up and click on File, New. And then we're going to go to Layout, and we're going to select 50 inches wide by 26 inches in height. We're going to make the DPI 300 because that will work better for print. And we'll click on Color, CMYK. Great. So I'm going to click on Create now. So from this point, I'll just knock up a really simple image. Okay, the minimalist art is complete, and you can go ahead and export that. File, export. So from this point, it's up to you to decide which export option you want to choose, PDF, etc. I'm going to click on PDF for now, and I'm going to go and press export. And I'll just save this to the desktop as wall art. And I'm going to click on save. Okay, that's saved as a PDF. Now I'm going to go over and place that image in here so I can see what it looks like in the scene. So I'll head on over to the place tool, click on that. And I will choose wall art, and I'll click on open. Now from this point, remember my snapping is still on. I can click in the top left corner, click and drag out until it snaps to the right bottom corner, and let go. So this is how the artwork will look when he places it on his wall. Of course, I can jazz it up a bit and add a frame, etc. But you can go ahead and print the artwork here, and it will arrive exactly the size here, as long as they have given you the correct measurement. So that's just one scenario where the measure tool comes in really handy if you're maybe creating something for an art gallery and you need to measure out how much room you have before you start creating your art, or whether your current art will actually fit in that space by using the measuring tool. Now, if you long press on the measure tool, you'll see there's an area tool, and I'll save that for another video. But I hope that was of some use to you, and I'll see you on the next video. Cheers.